Let me just say that I realize that it's early December, but I've already had to start thinking ahead to AECON, which is
I know.
6 months away. And I know there are people who plan even further ahead than that.
Me.
It's like, I haven't even really gotten into AllCon stuff, which is in 3 months.
I know, we really got to get into that
There's no way I'm going to have anything done in time for Marvelous Nerd Year's Eve
Oh,
at the rate I'm going. Definitely not going to have Soraka done.
no.
I might have Umi done if I take a day to finish what I need to finish with her, or I could just wear Pyrrha again. Because that's warm. I think that's one of the few warm things I have that isn't Renaissance, and I can always bring my Renaissance gear. It's like, okay, so I have to start thinking about AllCon and what I'm going to wear for AllCon. I have to start thinking about what I'm going to have done for all for AECON if I'm going to go to that. It's like, are there any other cons I'm going to next year besides that?
A lot of shit to think about.
It is, especially when I have to consider that real life is getting really good at getting in the way
Yeah,
when
that's
I
the
need to
fun
be
thing.
productive.
Yeah. As you get older, I've noticed that real life has been getting so much more in the way that my free time has been dwindling drastically.
I haven't had any free
It's been
time.
ridiculous. It almost seems like every day I get up to get ready, go to work. I'm at work, drive home, take care of my puppies, eat dinner, go to bed. Like I have no, I can't do anything else.
And you don't really have opportunity to work on things at work
Right.
because it's either against policy or it would look bad if somebody saw you doing it.
Or you're working through your lunch like I always have to, apparently.
Well, I work out over my lunch, so I'm physically like in another place.
At least you're being way more productive than I am.
I have to. I'm doing better
Good.
at losing what I got, but I still have a long way to go. And I have to enforce 5 days a week workout. So I give up my lunch 3 days a week, and then I do 2 days a week on my off days. I don't like doing it. I really don't like doing this. I would rather just bury myself under my electric blanket and not do squat, but I do it
Oh,
anyway.
electric blanket. Oh, that
I
sounds good right now.
know the feeling.
Yeah, I did not want to get out of bed this morning because it was just like me and the warmth of my heating pad. And I was like, oh, do I really have to go to work today?
So I when I put together my cosplay schedule to try and get certain costumes done in time for certain cons, I allotted 2 months per costume because it's like, oh yeah, life's gonna get in the way. And then it's like, yeah, I allotted 2 months, but I actually only have about one. And that's if I'm having a really good one. Otherwise it's more like 2 weeks when
Right.
life isn't getting in the way. And it makes me feel really bad like about my cosplay ability, simply because it's not like you can take 2 weeks off of work and just grind on a costume. And I get that there are people who can, haul together costumes in 3 days or a week. Those people tend to eschew and or eschew, take your pick, whatever. But
It's you.
anyways, it means they give up sleep. And it means that their day job tends to suffer if they have a day job that is not cosplay. My job, I can't do that. I can't give up sleep because it's a job and I can't afford to have it do that. And I can't just randomly take time off. So it's like I'm kind of at the mercy of being an adult and I can't always get done what I want to get done. So it does make me feel a little bit bad.
Adulting sucks. It's joyous in some areas, but it sucks in others.
Yeah, especially when you're having to take a class, which
Yeah.
means I've been stuck doing homework for the last 3 weeks, and I still have about another week's worth of homework to go before I can slow down. It's like, okay, that means I can't realistically work hard on Soraka for at least another week. Well, that's going to put me at 6 weeks to finish that costume. And given that Spark Fun is out of my electronic components, I'm not sure I'm going to have that done in 2 months,
Probably
six weeks.
not.
And that doesn't even account that I was supposed to technically have Umi finished by a week and a half ago. And the skirt is not fully done. and I still have to make the neck wrap, and I still have to add the magnetic closure to the coat. It's like, oh, there's still stuff I have to do. I just haven't really been able to sit down and do it.
Yeah, that's the hard part. I have to say, I'm glad that I've done two things, and the first thing is that I really haven't set myself deadlines on most of my costumes anymore. There's a couple of things, like there's two that I have to do by AECON. I've got 6 months to do it. I've got enough time. I can make it happen. But the rest of the stuff, I mean, if they get done, great. If they don't get done, that's okay. They'll be debated another time. I'm not forcing myself to a bunch of deadlines and schedules this year. And I've noticed that I'm actually enjoying crafting again because of it. But the other thing that I've been doing is I'm really glad I decided to do that 2 days a week I'm streaming, and that's forcing me to get into crafting again. And it's getting me inspired because I'm watching other people crafting as they stream too. And it's like, okay, this is the motivation that I've been needing for so long, and I just haven't gotten there. It's like, this is like my renewed Mythbusters, because Mythbusters used to be like my go-to show to watch whenever I was crafting, because it was always inspiring to me. They make crap out of nothing, and here, it's a cannon. So seeing other people craft has been the kick in the butt that I've needed.
I'd love to do that if I wasn't doing homework.
I know, that's the hard part. It's like when you have these things you have to take for work and for life and whatever.
Obligations.
You got obligations, and you got to do those first. There's priorities. You finish your priorities, and then you can go have fun.
And as much as I would like to just not work on costumes on a deadline, my issue is that none of my current costumes fit except Pyrrha. Everything else literally does not fit me anymore because I'm too big. So that means I have nothing to wear to a con that is not Renaissance. So if I want to wear something to a con, I have to crack down and make something. Because I got nothing.
I'll see if I can push out Blake for the end of the month. Probably won't happen, but I'll try.
Well, assuming that I have until end of January to finish Soraka, might be doable because I don't have too much going besides basically New Year.
Yeah.
However, I have Athena scheduled for a remake February, March. Probably not going to get that done. Simply because I have a ton of stuff going between February and March. And then I have Pyrrha scheduled for April, May, so that she's done by AECON. Because the idea was that I was going to take Soraka, Athena, Pyrrha to AECON. And then Umi as a casual. That was going to be it. Nope. Don't think it's going to happen. So I will finish Pyrrha for the Ruby group, because I know there's going to be one. I will finish Soraka, because Water Gardens. And I'll probably just end up having to take Umi with me. And that'll be it.
If it helps any, our Ray Earth kids are coming together too. So there you go. You won't be alone. Join us on all the things.
I tried to last time.
We'll make it work this time.
Yeah, I actually have to redo portions of Prasea if I was going to bring her to. Since the collar doesn't fit anymore. I'm betting the bodysuit probably doesn't either. Oops.
Growing up. It's a thing.
And growing out, unfortunately.
Yeah, up, so out, in. Upside down,
hey,
whatever.
Man, having a desk job is not helping me, and stress is really not helping me either. And I ended up having to change medications too, because I honestly think that the medication that I had switched to was part of the problem.
Oh, that's never fun.
Back, and I've only been on it for like 3 weeks. So I won't know for probably another month or so if it's actually having any effect.
Yeah. Drugs are bad.
Tired all the time, though.
Drugs are bad, okay?
Well, drugs are bad until they're necessary. Which, this is one of those times when I really need this one.
Kind of a thing.
Until insurance will pay for a permanent mitigation,
right?
Medication has to stand in its place.
Still working on that part too.
Yeah,
the permanent solution
not gonna happen.
Yeah. Oh, wait, political talk, steering. Steer away.
I wasn't going any further.
Hard left.
It is going to make Halloween interesting next year, though.
God. Because I didn't see as many people wearing political costumes at Halloween this year. I think they're going to be
not this year.
Yeah, I think they're going to be more abundant. Because usually whenever it's an election year, they always have, like, you know, the two candidates. They have their masks. Things. Yeah. No, this was the year of David Pumpkins.
There will be all sorts of parody costumes next year, I'm sure. Plus with the new Marvel movies coming out,
mm-hmm.
there will be a lot more choices too.
We have new Star Wars movie, new Spider-Man movie, a third reboot. Jeez.
There's Wonder Woman movie,
mm-hmm.
Avengers flicks.
Does the Justice League come out next year?
I don't know if that's next year or 2018.
Time to Google. Hang on. Justice League movie, Ben Affleck. I'm going to make it as easy as possible. Release date, November 17th, 2017. Darn. So technically next year. So they may have a couple of costumes out by then because sometimes they'll do that.
Something else, RPF will already have builds done.
Oh, God, yes. I mean, Aquaman looks stellar.
I love her costume in that.
Oh, man, yeah. Oh.
Mira, yeah.
Oh. They look amazing. They did good. I really appreciate the way that they have really modernized so many of the superhero costumes. So you could tell that they're special and they don't look like super comic booky because comic book costumes are kind of.
incidentally, for those of you looking to do charitable giving around this time of year, if you don't have a chosen charity, consider making a donation to your local makerspace. A lot of cosplayers don't really know about makerspaces, and they can be places where you can not only work on your projects among other like-minded people who like to make things, but they tend to have a lot of tools that average people can't get their hands on, like laser cutters and sandblasters and CNC machines, 3D printers, that sort of thing. And they're free to use as long as you're a member of the makerspace. Or sometimes they'll have one-off days where you can just go in. They're kind of show and tell, open house kind of days, but you can go in and use their equipment on those days too. And they have some pretty rad stuff. They've even, some makerspaces have computerized sewing machines, so you can do embroidery there too. So if you need a place to donate, consider your local makerspace because they will make very good use of your money. And a lot of local makerspaces are nonprofit or not-for-profits. You don't even have to necessarily donate to be a member. You can just donate and say, hey, you know, here's $100. Go and purchase something to help your members out. And they will.
They'll make good use of it.
Oh, yeah. There's all sorts of geeky things that they can make. I know my local makerspace is teaching people how to make drones right now.
Nice.
How to pilot them.
Nice.
And I know that the Dallas makerspace has actually recently been teaching people how to life cast and how to mold and cast.
Yep.
And they've actually had workshops where you pay a nominal fee. So they're running what are effectively cosplay classes at local makerspaces here in Dallas. And I found their classes too.
It's cool stuff.
So well worth it.
Yeah, definitely.
And if you don't have a makerspace,
poke. Play catch up. Waiting on it to catch up.
What?
You started going robot on me again.
You didn't do anything.
I didn't do squat. I didn't do diddly or squat. It went silly.
You were dead silent, and I thought something was wrong.
Oh, yeah. Well, your camera is currently not working now. There it goes. It's back to normal. Now we're good. It was buffering. It was doing the thing. It was playing catch up. You're good now.
Google's fault. And Frontier's fault, too.
Yeah. I was about to drop the F-bomb. Frontier deserves it, though. Frontier deserves all the F-bombs. Oh, goodness. Yes, that. That's exactly what it is. I'm going to make a meme out of that.
Good times.
Good times, man. Good times.
I considered, because this is the time of year when you get a bunch of fan art, Christmas fan art, mm-hmm. of various characters doing, you know, holiday things. It's like, you know, Miss Pyrrha. Heaven knows there's a ton of fan art.
God, yes. No kidding, right?
I mean, the nice thing about holiday fan art is that the majority of the pictures are casual clothing. Mm-hmm. You can still be casual comfy. It's awesome, because it maybe a hat, a very loose sweater, and then some sort of pants. They're usually not slacks. They're either jeans or they're sweats.
Yeah, everybody seems to do like the ugly sweater thing. Like, that's just the easiest thing that you can throw on, stick on a Santa hat, done. You've holiday themed your cosplay.
Or just a red sweater. Just
yeah.
A blank red sweater.
But it's totally way more doable. Fun with ugly sweaters.
True. I'm doing Christmas Zelda next year for TRF.
There you go. See? Done.
Just same outfit for Twilight Princess, just changing up the colors. That's pretty much it. I'm taking it with me to Celtic Christmas.
There you go. See, that's all you need to do. You don't have to be crazy.
And then I have to paper craft rubies. Not to the little kids.
Yeah, that'd be cute.
Because that's what they do for medieval Christmas, is the things mm-hmm. to people, because it's Christmas.
That's cute.
It's like, oh, now I have to just get a bunch of cardstock, because they have Pepakura rupees.
Yeah, those are really easy to make. Yeah, they're easy. I know.
Either spray paint them or nail polish them.
And I've made them before, Amy. Prior, before papercraft and all this was a thing, is like, I've actually made those before out of origami, and they broke apart in the middle so you could actually split them and put stuff inside them.
Now that's a thought. I could actually put something in them, but I'd have to make them splittable if I did that. I'll have to think about it.
Not really, because it really depends. Like, I was able to put like Tootsie Rolls in them, no problem.
Well, typically with Pepakura, you actually seal the tab shut.
So yeah.
You can't.
So you can't open it, no.
Right. I would have to make it splittable, which means I don't glue all the tabs down. And it doesn't look as clean that way when you do it that way.
Yeah, that's why I like to do it with origami.
Yeah, it's one all of those things.
Yeah, it's weird with Pepakura if you don't have all the tabs down, because then you're just like, this is not... I think that would kill my OCD. My OCD would just go bananas at that point.
Yes. And I didn't want to make them out of something heavy like clay.
Yeah, no. That's too much.
Yeah.
Make them out of paper, toss them in a bag. Done.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, just make a bunch of those and then just stick them in a pouch.
That's a cute idea. I like that, Amber.
Got to festive it up here.
Yeah. We can have our moments. Clearly, I'm so festive over here. You're way more festive right now than I am, that's for sure.
Because this is the warmest sweater I own.
Yeah, exactly. It's like, what was the warmest thing I can put on? This works.
This has only got to hold me until bedtime, because then I have electric blanket.
And then you just pile them on.
Hey, man. Santa gave that to me. Best gift ever.
Right? It's always the little things, like the electric blanket.
Electric blanket, because it's queen size, so each half operates independently.
Nice.
So I can actually control the heat levels on both sides. It's like a Tempur-Pedic style.
Blanket.
Yeah, it's a Tempur-Pedic style heating blanket.
Nice.
Oh, yeah. Good times.
All right, I vote that we call this, because I'm ready to go.
Woo!
Yay!
Sounds good to me. All right, thanks guys for being here for the after session. See you guys next time.
And remember, social media stuff here. Drop us a line. You know the deal. Bye, kids!